Hello, welcome back to Children's Liturgy. This week we're going to be talking about getting ready. I don't know about your family, but my family spent this past week getting ready for Christmas. We decorated the house. We put up some of our favorite things. And one of our favorite things is our nativity set, just like the nativity set we have here. Now, I do want you to take a minute to look closely at our nativity. Is everybody there? No. We're missing Mary and Joseph, the donkey they rode in on. We're missing baby Jesus. We don't have the three kings. That's because in children's liturgy, we remember that Bethlehem was a place that existed before Jesus and Mary and Joseph were there. Bethlehem was a town filled with townspeople who did normal, ordinary things, including that very special innkeeper. Right now, we're going to get back to talking about being ready. Being ready is preparing for something. Just like we were preparing for Christmas by putting up our decorations, doing a little bit of shopping, we're also preparing during the season of Advent to recognize what a marvelous gift the birth of Jesus was for all of us. Now, when you're preparing for something, it involves waiting sometimes. And waiting can be really hard. Waiting for Christmas is hard, especially if you're excited about maybe something special coming into your life in the way of a present. The best gift for Christmas, we all know, was the fact that God sent Jesus to us to help us learn best how to live in the world, how to be part of the kingdom of God that starts right here on earth. But when we're waiting, it can be frustrating. Just like we're probably still pretty frustrated that things aren't normal yet. We still are wearing our masks. We're still maybe not going to school in the classroom. We might not have even seen our family and friends for Thanksgiving. Things can be frustrating, but I want you to remember, you can always pray to God and talk to Him about your frustrations. Today, in our very first reading, Isaiah tells his people that God wants to come and visit him. Isaiah is talking to the people in the Old Testament, before Jesus was born. But there's a problem. God has no road. He has no way to get to his people. So listen to what Isaiah says to help get the people ready. This is a reading from the book of Isaiah. A voice is shouting, "Clear a path in the desert for the Lord. Build a straight road there for our God. Fill in the valleys, flatten the mountains and the hills. Level the rough and rugged ground. Then the glory of the Lord will appear for all of us to see. The Lord has promised this, the word of the Lord." And all together we say, thanks be to God. Now we're going to listen to a song that talks about getting ready, preparing for the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Back in Lent, we had a shofar. I don't know if you remember back that far, but it was a horn. It was big and noisy, and it made an unusual sound. That sound was a call to the Jewish people to gather and be sorry for the ways that they had not been ready for God, the ways that they had made mistakes. So when you listen to this song, you're going to hear the shofar at the beginning.
Prepare ye the way. of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord.
And the Israelites traveled 40 years through the desert. And the people who were in exile in Babylon that Isaiah was preaching to were in a land that did not have a lot. Jerusalem, where Jesus lived, is surrounded by a desert. It doesn't take very long to get from the city of Jerusalem out to the desert. A couple years ago, my mom and sister visited Jerusalem, and they were surprised at just how close the desert was. In the New Testament, we have stories about the desert. We have stories about Jesus going out into the desert before he starts preaching and teaching to the people. Today, we're going to hear another story that involves the desert. In today's gospel, John the Baptist was a person, a prophet, whose job was to get ready for Jesus. His job was to teach people about Jesus. And one of the things he did to help people get rid of their sins was to baptize them in the River Jordan. In those days, people received baptism to show that they were sorry for their sins. The water symbolized the fresh, clean, new lives that they wanted to live. We'll stop now for a minute. I want you all to stand. If you have an instrument, please get it. And then we're going to sing the Alleluia together. One, two, ready, go. So that you show respect for the reading of the gospel. The reading The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to Mark. And we make the sign of the cross on our foreheads and on our lips and on our hearts. And all together we say, Glory to you, O Lord. This is the good news about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. It began just as God had said in the book written by Isaiah the prophet. I am sending my messenger to get the way ready for you. In the desert, someone is shouting, Get the road ready for the Lord. Make a straight path for him. So John the Baptist showed up in the desert and told everyone, Turn back to God and be baptized. Then your sins will be forgiven. From all of Judea and Jerusalem, crowds of people went out to the desert to see John. They told how sorry they were for their sins, and he baptized them in the river Jordan. John wore clothes made of camel's hair. He had a leather strap around his waist and ate grasshoppers and wild honey. John also told the people, Someone more powerful is going to come, and I am not good enough to even untie his sandals. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord. And all together, we say, Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I'd like you to sit down now. We're going to do the profession of faith. Your response will be, Yes, I do. Do you believe in God the Father, who sends his Son to show you his glory? And you answer, Yes, I do. Do you believe in God, the Son, our Lord Jesus, for who you need to prepare the way? Yes, I do. Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit, given to you at the time of your baptism? Yes, I do. Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the gathering place of all the baptized? Yes, I do. We're going to close with one prayer, and then we'll be all finished. Jesus, come into every home of every family and fill it with your light and peace. Amen. Thank you for coming to see us on our virtual children's liturgy.